All right, Jason Ruona back here in the hobby store here at Speed RC. We're talking about JConcepts products right now. I got my personal B6 out here this weekend, been doing some racing. Track's been awesome here at Speed, having a great time. I've been helping the guys test some tires and breaking in some things of my own and competing out there in two-wheel mod and 40-plus mod. So it's been a great racing experience here. Brought a few items that we wanted to kind of show off here this weekend. First of all, we have upcoming, which is going to be the servo mount bracket for the B6, which we had a popular version for the B5 series of cars, and now we'll have one for the B6 as well. Got that here on the car. Of course, I already have the already released aluminum steering parts. And then kind of moving towards the rear, I'm experimenting here this weekend with a different motor plate. Basically, it's kind of been a popular item here recently to have some type of shield over the gear, and that sits under the body that actually protects the spur gear from touching the body. And, you know, so what we did is we kind of have multiple ways that you can kind of do this. On Spencer's car, he's using a standard Team Associated motor plate. We made a 3D printed gear shield that we made available on the Shapeways store, and that's something that he's using this weekend, and along with some of the other guys. What we did here with mine is this is a full machined aluminum version that's a little more complicated, a little more intricate, but kind of has the same function and purpose. And so it's a full machined look, protects the spur gear, sits under the body. It's kind of a nice clean look. Kind of moving back into the center of the car, we've been experimenting with a different type of battery hold down brace for the car. Since I'm running the low profile Reedy battery here, we designed a battery brace that was just as low profile, but screws down instead of using the nut fastening system. So what we did is we kind of built this brace around the Reedy short pack, and it's working really well for me here this weekend. That'll probably be something we'll add to our store that's available. We'll also have a tall version that's for the taller battery. So a lot of the guys like Spencer we talked to earlier is running the new Zappers battery. It's the taller version, but so we'll have a brace that fits over the top of that one and down, but it'll secure with screws. So something that's just a little cleaner in the center and more specific to the battery that you're using. Something that I was kind of wanting to do when we did this is we just wanted to have more clearance in here between the battery and the body itself, because we're running the body so low, and we want to kind of utilize some extra space in there. So that's the brace itself. Moving here into the rear, we've been experimenting with just a different rear wing mount. This is a one-piece 3D printed version that I was just testing with here this weekend, and kind of unique because we have different adjustment holes on the mount itself. It's kind of a beefy setup, but a lot of guys, when you move the tower from the rear to the front, there becomes a situation where you want to move the wing. So with this, you don't have to add holes to the wing. The mount has holes, so you can move it on the mount itself, which has actually been kind of nice if you're switching around or you just want to try the wing further forward or further back. So I've been giving it some pretty serious durability testing on the triple here this weekend, and I've been pretty happy, you know, because when you miss the triple here, it's, you know, a direct shot, and I've been really happy with the way that that's been holding up. Alex K has been testing a waterfall for us, kind of a single, more of a single, we're calling like an elephant trunk almost, because the single post comes down as far as you can go and then spreads to two screws, and looking for a little more flex there. There's some popular setups out there where they take the waterfall completely off, move the battery back, and adds some flex. And with that mount, Alex is really something that he had asked for back at the Team Associated race. We're like, all right, well, we'll see what this guy can do. And we made him a mount, a waterfall, and he's doing well with it. So he was happy to test that out. And this weekend we've been experimenting with, of course, we talked to Spencer with the Octagons tire, but we got the space bars here on my car, which is was my favorite this weekend. I tried dirt webs, space bars, and I've been breaking in tires, helping Spencer a little bit, and really happy with this particular height, this particular setup of the space bar on my car, and as the track kind of goes along, and really happy with that setup. You know, dirt tech inserts, mono wheels, and just kind of straight out of the package, a little bit of break in track time, about four or five runs in, I felt the tires were in a really good place. So that's kind of my B6 here, kind of the chassis parts, going up to the top of the shocks. We got some titanium standoffs that we're working on. These are almost finished and ready to go out to the consumers and distributors, but it's a titanium standoff, has the thread extends through the front, and then you use a screw through the back. So short one in the front, standard length or long in the back, and that's something that everyone asks us for is, when are you guys going to make some shock standoffs? And this is it. So we're going to have a Delrin pivot bushing and then a titanium. It's kind of thin looking, what we call our turnbuckles, so they kind of match, kind of brings the whole car together. So that's kind of the B6 here at the Indoor National Finals. And thanks for joining us here with JConcepts. We appreciate all the tracks, especially Speed here hosting our finals this year, and great turnout. And thanks for joining us here with Red RC.